Executive Officer, Nigerians in Diaspora Commission, Abike Dabiru Erewa, has reiterated that autopsy must be conducted to ascertain the circumstances surrounding the death of Itonu Babalola in Cote d'Ivoire. She stated this during a visit to the ambassador of Cote d'Ivoire in Nigeria, in the nation's capital. Abike, while presenting a protest letter to the ambassador, stresses that the Nigerian government is determined to find the root causes of the death of its citizens, Itonu Babalola. She therefore appealed to Nigerians in diaspora to be of good behavior and abide by the rules and regulations of their host countries, even as they strive to always register their real identity in Nigerians' missions and place of residence.
Babalola Aka Abeki Paul, who died tragically in prison, while she was imprisoned in Cote d'Ivoire for an offense that she insisted she didn't commit. And from all investigation and legal opinion, she had said somebody burgled her house and she wanted justice. But it was said that the guy who burgled her house was related to an Ivorian policeman. And somehow, the case of burglary turned to human trafficking. At the end of the day, she was sentenced to 20 years imprisonment, which was committed to 10 years imprisonment, for an offense that she insisted she never committed. And from all available evidence, even with the legal people, she didn't commit that offense. The Nigerian mission had gone ahead to get a lawyer, had paid for the lawyer, and proceeded to appeal the case, because it was important for her to appeal and be freed of whatever they said she did. And then she fell ill and she died. So it's generated, of course, a lot of depression and anxiety, and naturally with the family and for all of us as parents too, that a young girl of 21, 22 lost her life in the process of seeking a better means of livelihood. So the father has officially written a letter, which I'll present to you. And also on our part, we have also written to the Interpol. We have an Interpol representative with us at the commission. We have informed the Interpol about this matter because it involves a policeman in Ivory Coast. So we just want is that Itunu's death should not be in vain. And even in death, she should get justice. So we believe that even the case should continue, even as she has died, and that an autopsy be done to determine the true cause of her death.
On his part, the Cote d'Ivoire ambassador to Nigeria, Traoré Kalilu, further pledges to collaborate with the Nigerian government to investigate the issue.
Working with our colleague, the ambassador of Nigeria to Abidjan, to follow the situation, we are in touch. And after receiving your letter, we will bring again the information to the Ivorian authorities so that they can do all their best to handle this issue. Cooperation between Cote d'Ivoire and Nigeria has gone a long way. We have a very large community of Nigerians, almost 3 million people on 25 million, living in Cote d'Ivoire in peace. And generally, there are no problem. And this incident is very unfortunate, and we are very sorry, and the government will do everything they can do in order to solve it and to avoid this kind of thing. And we would like again to condole with all the family and all the relatives of this young girl.
Reports added that Itonu's house in Abidjan, Cote d'Ivoire was burgled. While seeking justice, she took the case to the police for proper investigations. However, upon filing the case, she used Ms. Becky Paul instead of her real name, Itonu Babalola, to write a statement. Unfortunately, the case turned against her as she was later accused of human trafficking and later gave up to the ghost while in Cote d'Ivoire prison. Vincent Okushi, Quality Television.